C63 2013 with 90,000 kilometers. That's the cross member. That's the transmission. This from the side.
That's the car.
That's the bonnet. We are hiding the number plate, obviously. Okay. Let's go to see the engine. That's the exhaust. I said before that has all four catalytic converters on the car, and that looks healthy. So do the light, actually. Now it's dark, you can't see nothing. And the only modification of what I saw on the car, it's this one. This is what I was saying, that it just canceled the customer the silencer or muffler, what has from this spot until this spot. But this doesn't make any difference. Maybe it increased, let us say, a couple of decibel. But from the emissions and this stuff, it's fine, the car. Let's go to see the engine. First, I'm going to show you the engine that we removed from the car. And it's on the engine stand. Yeah, it's disaster the floor, obviously. All right. This is the engine. It's on the engine stand. Okay. And the customer, he told me that he wants all of his parts, all of the old parts that he has. What does mean that one? Intake manifold, fuel injectors, covers, camshafts, hydraulic lifters, the solenoid valves here front, that they didn't fix it also properly. From what I see here, they leave it on the air, hanging, and most probably also the same thing from this side. No, it's okay. So, water pump, alternator, power steering pump, AC compressor, idle pulleys, guided pulleys, belt, the secondary air injection, the valves over there up, everything except the engine itself. I'm gonna swap on this engine. On this engine, I didn't wash it. I just only strip it off. I remove everything. Just only don't think that I wash one engine, you know, to see. It has very low mileage. Has normal carbon, what you see on the M156 all the time. This one, if you put one fuel injector cleaner, you're gonna clean all this mess. It's not too much, but the valves are clean. They don't have, yeah, you know, the valley here, it's perfectly clean. I didn't touch it, I didn't clean it, but it has sand. My priority was to remove the camshafts, so to be closed the valves. When they close the valves, cannot fit anything inside. And then I'm opening all the rest. It's nice and safe. Also here, it didn't fit anything inside. So we're gonna compare actually this engine with this engine that has 90,000 kilometers. They told us that this engine is very low mileage, and you can see also that it was running with coolant, does have any oxidation inside, the same thing for the water pump. The damper pulley has also the sticker with the barcode. I saw it somewhere here. Yeah. There is no any leak. The oil filter housing here that's located here, it's very clean, does have any sludge or something. Same thing also here, where is the gear that's it's coming too much sludge inside. This looks excellent. The camshaft was very clean. Flex plate, obviously. The breather, the same thing. We'll go and compare this engine with this engine. And the camshafts, one second, because I put the camshafts here. I have the camshaft adjusters and the bolts. I believe that nobody lost it before. I was the first guy that he lost the bolts, and the camshafts are in excellent condition. I believe this is the hydraulic lifters here. Need to break the... to clean it actually. It does have a single mark, and even there is also the lines on the camshafts, the color, to recognize which one is exhaust, which one is intake. So yeah. Now, what I have to do, I want to drain the oil from this engine. I want to make it upside down and clean the ports inside without coming anything here inside. Most probably gonna put again the covers to cover it, to don't come anything inside. Then I'm gonna wash it, since the valves are completely closed, they're missing everything. Then I'm gonna close it here up, and then I'm gonna clean a bit front, clean a bit from this side inside to be nice and clean and dry, not with petrol because there are the valve seals inside and you can burn it. So yeah, there is possibility, you know what, maybe I can open also the oil pan down, the small one, to see how it is inside. This is because I opened the dipstick and there was oil inside and it came some oil out. You can see the marks, the sealant, always what you see from the factory, too much. The bolts, they don't have a single mark that somebody touched before. Yeah, that's it, that's it. Let's continue with this. Swap everything, but actually taking some parts from this one and put it here need to be washed, everything, one by one. Even the things that are outside and the things that are inside, the parts that are outside and inside. The customer, he informed me that the breather here back, he changed it 2-3 weeks ago, so I'm gonna keep it, I'm gonna transfer it. Definitely I'm gonna use new intake manifold gaskets and exhaust manifold gaskets. I want to see the seals on the cover to see if it's nice and healthy, and the small smile what has here the solenoids, plus need to be open the solenoids and clean it one by one because there are small things inside. Yeah, you can see the video of all these things. These pieces that are coming apart, I have it from this engine and they are very healthy. That looks like brand new. But this sponge, this foam, what's that? It's coming apart. But from that engine, it's like a brand new. Actually, I have it over there. Let me show you one second. And before the customer, he didn't have the buds here. The customer, he didn't have these buds. And now we found one for him. I'm talking about this one. This is from the engine that I opened, the used engine. It looks like a brand new, only has some dust. Yeah, that's it. That's the status with the vacuum, what you see over there, the vacuum cleaner. I use it just only to suck from here because there was some garbage over there, and I suck from this side and this side to don't fall inside when I'm gonna open the intake manifold. I know the valves are closed, but there's no problem. Better to, why to have garbage inside? And there is already carbon. I need to make it more. Ah, the caps also, the camshaft adjuster caps, the here that's holding down the camshaft. Nobody opened it before. You can see that it's on the correct position. The bolts were stuck down. You can feel it actually when you open it for first time. Yeah, that's it. That's it. The damper pulley, the marks what you see, there was not any mark here. I make the marks because I turn the damper pulley and I make it on the 40 degrees to remove the... I have it on the 40 degrees, right? Yeah, it's on 40 degrees. To remove the camshafts. So, yeah, that's the status now. Opening, cleaning, transferring. First clean this one, actually put in the engine room. Yes, I'm gonna put inside the engine room this one, better. When I'm gonna clean it, and then one by one the parts from this, I'm gonna swap it, I'm gonna put it inside. And we're gonna compare it. We're gonna compare this engine with this engine. That's it. I'm gonna start now, so I don't know if I make another video today. Okay, if I don't make today another video, I'm gonna make tomorrow. There is no problem. That's it. Thank you very much. Now, before I touch the camshafts, this is the C63 2013. The customer, he told me that he changed intake camshafts in the agency. And it looks like brand new. The point is... missing one piece. Hey, well done, guys. Good job. we'll figure out. Let's see from the other side. What's from the other side? No, from the other side, it's okay. All right, so now let's see this engine. Let's see how much carbon has. If it focuses camera, ever. Focus, please. Yeah, let's make it manual. Not telling the correct. Yes, okay. Sorry for my nose, but I still have a flu. Yeah. It's not too much. I have seen worse than this. I don't have a clue what's that in the center of the engine. Because if it is a coolant, how in here it reaches over there? So this hurts, looks like. Let me turn off the light. I'm gonna turn it off. This is just only. I want for the customer to see. One second to get the light. This is the wire harness. I have it there down. So these are the parts here. Need to be washed all these parts. And from this side, intake manifold. You can see also this mark here. This is a headache. I have to wash this one. I have to wash the lines. I have to wash the oil, the oil filter, the oil cooler. You can see here some marks. How they inserted down here and here. Yeah, never mind. Also need to open the solenoids and clean it. The covers, everything. Cam adjusters need to be open one by one. The rings. That looks okay. Okay. So now compare this engine, how it looks like. Alright. With this engine. I mean, let's make it from back, alright? Like this. And like this. Even the carbon, what has inside, it's not. The ports are clean. Honestly, I didn't wash the valley here. This is how I remove it. I didn't even touch it. I didn't even wash inside or something. It's the same story here. Yeah. All right. Let's turn also this one. Why in hell the sealant is like that? I don't know. Anybody open it or what? Who knows? I have no clue. I don't know. The only thing what I know is that the used engine, which looks better than this one that's 90,000 kilometers. The ports, the cylinder heads, even the spark plugs. If you see the spark plugs on this engine and you compare it with this engine, this has 10 times better spark plugs. We're gonna put new, I know that, but I'm saying. Okay, that's it. Let's remove camshafts, hydraulic lifters. Hydraulic lifters, 32. I have to break to clean them and remove the pressure from inside because the oil is glowing. Yeah, actually you can see on the previous video how it was. Yeah, it's nice and shiny. Take a look. Yeah, the camera you can also. Nice. Yeah, that's it. That's the end. Now, tomorrow starting washing, preparing. First clean a bit this engine to make it perfect. To be nice since the valves are closed, and I'm gonna open also the oil pan down here to be okay. Clean the surface also here since all the valves now are closed. Yeah, prepare it, put it inside the engine room, and then one by one the parts, whatever it's ready, first I'm gonna start with the hydraulic lifters and the camshafts, put it on, and then with the rest. Yep. I'm gonna see tomorrow also the intake manifold to open it. So what has the side, actually you can open only from down here, or if you put it on the side, usually it's come start coming oil from the port. I'll gonna see. Yeah, that's it. Thank you very much. Continue tomorrow.